Fremont and West Seattle, situated along the shores of Puget Sound, where ocean-going vessels from many nations of the world make use of a natural harbor long famous among seafaring men. Here, in a perfect setting of scenic splendor, the city is bounded on one side by the salt water of the Sound, on the other by the graceful, quiet waters of shimmering Lake Washington. Seattle has grown in the past 50 years to be a young metropolis, a husky, strong, ambitious youngster as compared with the cities of the nation, and yet a most important factor in the commercial traffic of a changing world. Seattle, the thriving newcomer among metropolitan areas of the West Coast, is built like Rome on a group of high, steep, and yet amazingly beautiful scenic hills. Nowhere in the world does the traveler revel in such natural splendor or find such views of mountains, lakes, residential treasures as in this northwestern paradise center. Realizing the necessity for efficient public transportation, Mayor Arthur B. Langley, during his administration, tackled this problem. This film has the purpose of showing the transformation from rails to rubber, a change establishing a modern system in the realm of municipal transportation, truly an epic-making accomplishment, completed in 1 year. As in most cities of comparable growth, the original transportation facilities in Seattle became outmoded and hopelessly inadequate to serve a population of almost 400,000. And this is a true story of transportation progress. Seattle marches on.
Thank you. Gentlemen, I'm asking you to assume a very heavy responsibility. As you know, our transportation system for a number of years has been in very bad shape. We didn't know how much longer we might be able to continue to operate the present system. But we did know that it couldn't be for very long. Through this loan from the Reconstruction Finance Corporation, we believe we can set up a modern, up-to-date transportation system that, if operated on a business basis, will serve the needs of this city very well, eventually pay for itself, and make it possible to extend and improve the services that the people of this city are entitled to. It is a big job. It is one that I'm confident you men can do. And it's gratifying to me to know that you're willing to accept the responsibility. I'm asking you, and I know that you will, make sacrifices in order to successfully manage this system.
Certainly trying to do the best we possibly can to complete this job.
I want to second Mr. Beckett's assurances. It does promise to be a very difficult task. Undoubtedly, we have a great deal to learn, but I'm sure that all three of us will apply ourselves to both learn and to give it the business administration needs to best.
I think you and your committees have completed the hardest part of the work in preparing the Enabling Act, the engineering survey, and the financing. I think it's now the point of the committee to keep their eye on the ball and follow through. I think we will be successful.
Thank you. Gentlemen, I appreciate your assuming this responsibility, and I know you're going to do a good job.
Thank you.
boy.
Yeah, thank you.